can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. You can't touch this. My music hits so hard,
makes me say, oh my lord, the music stopped. Hello fellow hunters, this is Tempered Kirin, by the way. What happens when you reach the highest maximist defense possible currently in world, just shy 1400? Well, I mean, I don't want to throw hyperbole out there, but essentially, Kirin, you can't actually kill me.
Oh.
So we're going to be getting to some dirty maths and a build, but before we do that, we should look at how we achieve such high defense. Will it be thanks to Kulve Taroth's booty?
Say what?
So, every single piece of Kulve Taroth when fully augmented is tied for highest defense in the game with Xenogeva at 92 apiece. However, obviously Kulve Taroth gives us 2 slots per piece, which is more than Xenogeva, giving us more room to achieve, well, all of the defense. The other huge factor here, brought on again by Kulve Taroth, is her weapons. Now, there is technically a switch axe with plus 40 defense. However, I prefer the insect glaive because I don't have the switch axe, even though I've farmed her forever. I don't have my greatsword that I want from her either, but that's okay. Sorry. So, this insect glaive comes with 30 defense and with 3 augment slots for 3 more. That takes it up to plus 60 from just the weapon. So all of this together, including decorations that we're about to go over, comes to 601 defense, just stood in a starer and unbuffed outside of armor talent and armor charm, which is pretty tasty. Don't eat the armor. So in terms of decorations then, we're looking at this. 6 defense boosts, 3 from a charm, 3 from the jewels for plus 30. Triple fire and triple thunder, because once you have all 3 of a resistance, you get an extra 10 normal physical defense. And by the way, you add that on top of this armor's already insane fire and thunder defense, the little bit extra you get from having rank 4 in just normal defense. It's hilarious. So elemental defense is just a percentage. So if you have 43 fire defense, you take 43% less fire damage. Kind of makes sense. So really, like, with this armor set, Teostra Tempered Supernova.
You serious?
Look, Teostra, don't be embarrassed, man. Sometimes you just can't get your supernova to work, and that's, you should not be ashamed of that. So, after that then, we still squeeze in a little bit of fortitude for 30% more defense when we die. So, the process for all of the defense is die twice, eat the defense up large, have yourself an adamant seed, have yourself hard shell powder, have yourself a mega armor skin, find a hunting horn user, this step might be the hardest, it's like wrangling fucking unicorns, and convince them to give you a defense up XL, then hope that your kitty cat with Coral Orchestra gives you a defense up, rush into battle and take an adamant pill, and then we end up at about 1340. So, if we throw Rocksteady on top of that, which is another 30% less, granted we're taking such little damage at this point that there's not much to half, but you know, every little helps. I mean, Tempered Nergigante Dive Bomb. He tried, bless him. So, now that we've kind of got this going on, what actual maths are we looking at then? Because it'd be nice to know what all of this ridiculous amount of defense actually translates to, because I know what you might be asking.
Well, is it even worth it?
Well, the thing is, kinda not. So, let's get down to brass tacks, because it's evident we're basically taking no damage, but how does that translate to numeric usefulness? Well, firstly, we needed a test move. I chose Teostra Tail Swippy Sweep because it just was easy for me to consistently get hit by it. We just needed a physical attack that we can use as our trial, and since it doesn't do any damage difference between him all fired up and when he's relatively calm, that is all good. So, we're using Rocksteady Mantle for all of these because, one, we're trying to take the least damage possible, and two, it lets us has survived the hit on zero armor, so we can do trials at the low end for a good old comparison, 0 to 1000 armor. Rocksteady then is 30% damage reduction. Now, I realize that, you know, drawn kind of squiggly section comparison is as dirty as dirty maths gets. Hopefully my video doesn't get flagged for this. but it does at least give me an idea, and we'll get a little bit more precise towards later on. So, the difference between 0 defense and 10 defense is actually quite a fair amount. So, you take 15% less damage just gaining that first 10 points of defense. Teostra Tail Swipe, by my reckoning, does about 170 damage to no armor. This is including the mantle. And then with 10 armor, it's only 150. So we take that up again. Going to 250 defense takes that 150 damage and almost thirds it to 55. For another 65% reduction from 10. Then we go to the difference between 250 and 500. That 55 damage at 250 becomes 30 damage at 500 armor. So you see the scaling is starting to drop off really, really hard. So the big one then, 500 to 1000. Well, that 30 damage at 500 becomes just 18 at 1000. So only 12 off, but you know, we're kind of starting to get to the point where it's barely affecting the health bar. So what is this telling us then? Well, essentially, the difference between 0 and 1000 defense is 90% damage reduction. It is weighted heavily at the low end and gets less and less effective as we go up, but it's 90% reduction across 1,000. Now, I've not used the 1,300 because it's not realistic to be popping adamant pills, and frankly, the difference is so tiny it doesn't matter, but we can actually check this because in Monster Hunter, there has been a regular formula for working out how much your armor is worth, and that is 80 divided by 80 plus your armor times 100. So let's have a little check then to see how I did. We get about a 92% damage reduction. So to say I got 90, yeah, I can kind of buy that, right? So essentially, 1,000 defense is worth 90-ish percent damage reduction. So cool, right? Aren't you so happy for knowing that info? Doesn't it just fill you up with so many feels knowing now what the maximum defense is? Because I know that deep down, you love this video. No! So, now that we do know all this, is there really any practical use? Well, in the background, you've got my just AFK and don't die, but this time we can survive against tempered energy. AFK and not dying. I mean, I'm occasionally rebuffing with armor-based consumables, but really I'm doing scant little else. It's really quite fantastic, but the thing is, you might as well be attacking, right? If you're taking this much damage less, I'm just gonna leave that in at this point. I'm only human. You might as well be attacking. We can also vastly improve Pokemon Palico by a version that requires you to literally just stand still in the mantle, rebuffing, healing every now and then. We can use the glaive to let the insect do a load of damage, and that's kind of cool. Have a triple team attack in the monster at once, and you can get like a sub 20 minute tempered Teo like that in a most chill way you've ever seen. But again, like, you might as well be attacking, right? There's not like anything super cheesy this lets you do. So my favorite thing to do with this is actually a hunting horn build. Using the Joe horn, we can give ourselves the 30% more defense, 30% more attack, which obviously scales everything ridiculously high when we're using all the buff consumables too, because we're combining it with the wide range and the Palico rally, grabbing the Palico and just not stop hitting for nothing, especially during the mantle duration, but even then, you just don't have to heal. There's a health augment on the horn, as well as one defense, and by the way, level 3 Divine Blessing does stack with the Divine Blessing that you get from defense augments. So let's say you have a weapon with 3 defense augments and level 3 Divine Blessing, you have two separate 25% chances to take half damage going on at all times, which actually adds up to ridiculousness, and honestly, triple defense augment might be really super viable on a rare 6 weapon, but anyway, that's besides the point. You grab your palico, get the horn, you buff them up with the attack and yourself, you buff their defense, and you just don't stop attacking, and I actually get really quick kill times, like a sub 10 minute Nurgy. I realize on Nurgy, like, what the speedruns are like 1 minute to 2 minutes at this point. Hell, we've had a sub 1 minute temp quick. But, you know, for a cheesy fun build up using high defense with fucking Palico Rally, where you never stop attacking, basically ignore dodging whatsoever, and I don't know how to use a hunting horn, so I'm just kind of flailing around. Like, this is the theme song to me playing hunting horn. That's fine, right? And I have fun, and it's cool. So take it what you will. This was my look into reaching super high defense, and I hope you had fun. Like, if you did, or if you learned something. A lot went into this, and I really do appreciate it. Share it around if you thought it was worthy. Subscribe for more. My name's been Josh, and I'll see you next time. I spent so long looking into the defense value in a game. I'm just gonna go before I have my next existential crisis, I think. Okay.
Rage gaming with the video float.
But that's all that's really relevant at the mo, but I'm still gonna leave this up so you patrons know that I love you even though the outro's no longer that kinda relevant. But the new one's being worked on and it's gonna be a truly badass song, and don't worry, I won't be doing any rapping on it. I'm gonna go now. This was shit.